Hello students, welcome to this class of data analytics. I am Sahil Bansal, assistant professor in department of mechanical engineering in engineering college Banswara, Rajasthan. So this course will basically introduce you to the field of data analytics. Okay, see, basically data analytics is a very wide field and it involves lot of various subjects in it. Okay, which you need to understand this subject completely. So what we are going to do in this course, basically it will give you the flavor of how data analytics works. Okay, what are the various small concepts, more of them are theoretical concepts that we will introduce you to in this class. Okay, so yeah, so proceeding with it. First of all, the first question that arises in our mind, what is data, right? What is data? So it is nothing but, data is nothing but units of information, right? Data is units of information. So see, now the thing is, the everything we do today, everybody has mobiles, everybody is working on laptops, everybody is working on the internet, right? So we are generating lot of data every day, right? Be it geo data, which means to say locational data, be it cultural data, science data, financial data. It could be various statistics, right? It could be data about the weather, right? It could be data related to environment or transport data or any data, right? So basically it is a unit of information, okay, which is often numeric and collected through observation. Now, how this data is collected, that is also very important. Now, you can collect this data manually, right? Like you can visit the people and you can collect the information from them. Okay, you can collect the data? You can do this manually. Or what you can do? You can use sensors, right? There are some things like let's say you have a industry and you have a very large machinery installed over there. And you want to see whether there are certain vibrations occurring in that machine, or are there some problems, or the temperature is optimum or not. Maybe there is some temperature issue problems in your machine. Temperature is rising too much. So what we do, we install sensors over there. And what those sensors are doing, those sensors are collecting the data continuously over a period of time, and you are recording that data. So what data analytics will do, it will analyze that data, that what at what point of time the data temperature is increasing. So what is the task of data analytic engineer or data scientist? He can basically detect the abnormalities, okay? He can basically predict the outcomes. He can tell you beforehand that yeah, this problem could occur in this system, okay? So yeah, so this is basically data. And see, approximately 2.5 into 10 raised to power 9. So E plus 9, it means is 2.5 into 10 raised to power 9 GB of data is approximately being generated per day. See, everybody in this world today is generating data, right? Whenever you scroll the Facebook, you scroll the Twitter, you watch YouTube videos, you search for something in Google, that every transaction is being processed and recorded somewhere. Okay, so you can imagine that everybody is doing such transactions and that data is being generated every day. So there is a very large need of optimum solutions for the data science process. Okay, and we also need more of the data scientists in the market. So why this data analytics subject is being included in all the curriculums today? Initially it was not there. Now in mechanical engineering also, the subject is included. Why? Because data analytics is everywhere. You know, doesn't matter if you're a civil engineer, doesn't matter if you're a mechanical engineer, electrical engineer, you need to know how the data is analyzed. You need to know that how to get the insights from the data. Okay, but the task is, there is a lot of data. Then there are some tools and there are some technologies that you need to learn to get the insights from the data. And we will see what are those technologies. That will not be taught in this course completely, but yeah, we will get the flavor of that what are those technologies or how we can make use of that. Okay, so this is about what is data. Okay, it's basically information. Yeah. Okay. Next we have is what is analytics. Now, what is analytics? We have seen what is data. So data is nothing but information. Okay. Now analytics is when we are studying that data, right? So it is the systematic computational analysis of data and statistics. What it means, we are making sense of that data. Now data could be very random. Now let's say if I show you some Excel file and I ask you, let's say that Excel file contain 10,000 entries. Okay, now it is impossible for you being a human to get the insights from that data. How you can give me some graphs or something like that with just by seeing the data, how can you say that this is good or this is bad? Because there are 10,000 records in that Excel file and it's not possible for human. I am saying too less a number. There are billion of records. Okay, there are such applications or there are some such instances where we have multiple millions of records. But yeah, I am just for this purpose, I'm saying only 10,000. So let's say we have 10,000 of records. Okay, now you can't basically see it and say that, yeah, this data is good or this data is bad or this is going to happen or this is not going to happen. So it's not possible. So what we need computation. What is meant by computation? So see, now the technology is too advanced. We have supercomputers, right? Everybody in hands are very powerful machines. Your mobiles are even too powerful. Your laptops are too powerful now. So you can do the analytics on your own, right? And the most important thing that is happening today in this industry, that is cloud computing. Okay. That is cloud computing. Now, what is cloud computing? Now, you do not even need a powerful system in your hands physically. You can access it over the internet on the cloud. Okay, what it means? Now, let's say you have a laptop or your personal computer which has 8 GB of RAM, but you have a lot of data to process and you need about 16 GB of RAM. Now, what will you do? Are you going to buy that RAM? No, because of cloud computing, you need not to buy that RAM. What you can do? You can hire the system over the internet, use the system and then leave the system. Okay, there are many pioneers in this field that are working in this domain of cloud computing. Okay, like we have Amazon that is working in this field. You might have not heard it, but I will strongly recommend you explore it. It is a very good technology. AWS is there. Then we have Google. It is called GCP. It is Google Cloud Platform. Okay, and then we have Microsoft. It is Azure. Microsoft Azure. So these are basically pioneers in this field. However, there are many others also. We have IBM also. IBM also has its own cloud and many other players also in the market. But yeah, these are the pioneers basically. I will say AWS is way above everybody else, but yeah, still. So yeah, so basically computation is very easy these days. We can very easily process the lot of data. But can you? Do you know how to process that data? Have you ever processed that data? Now, this is a very important skill that you can have. I am telling you that if you are going to remain in this domain or for that matter, even if you're leaving the engineering domain, if you're doing the business or you're doing anything, if you know how to make sense of data, that will always be helpful to you, because it doesn't matter what you do, you will always have a data. Okay. So yeah, this is about analytics. So we have information, that is data. And then we perform analysis on that, which is analytics. So it is a systematic computation analysis of data and statistics. Okay. Okay. So we will meet in next class and we'll see further some basic concepts about the data analytics. Bye bye.